Hello there, this is IcyToonie here with another TF2 gameplay video. In this video I'm going to be playing as the soldier here on CP Well, and I'm actually going to be using the rocket jumper as opposed to the rocket launcher in this video. And the rocket jumper is a pretty cool weapon. It's basically a training weapon released by Valve that does zero damage in combat, so you're not going to be seeing me blow any rockets at anyone. Basically its uses are for rocket jumping around, as its name would suggest. When you do rocket jump, you're actually also going to take zero damage, so that's where the fun in this weapon really comes out, because basically you can just rocket jump around maps and try to fry pan some people to death, and also take out the shotgun from time to time to finish people off. So because the map here is Well is not known as one of the greatest maps for rocket jumping or just for mobility classes in itself. It kind of takes place indoors mostly, and that's never good. So you're not going to see me rocket jump around and do crazy stuff as I would in most maps, but I still am pretty successful in that, and hopefully in the future I'll be experimenting with the rocket jumper a little more and do some fun stuff on maps like Badlands or Granary, where you can jump around a little bit more. But for now, just kind of attacking the second point here with a medic. It's always helpful to have a medic here. I don't really like showing too many videos where I have pocket medics with me, because I'd like to show you guys how you can also be successful without them. But for now, because this is one of my first times using the rocket jumper, I will take the help. I think he actually noticed that I was using this setup and wanted to help me out a little bit, so that's always nice. But right now I really have to be careful, because it's really hard for me to go into situations like that with no backup and a lot of places for the enemy to attack me without my rocket launcher. So with this setup you really have to be a lot more careful, because I don't really have the ability to rocket jump out of situations, especially indoors here. I just really have to be more selective with who I target. Like right now, kind of just surprise jumping onto the point. We're actually able to take the point, which is nice. So there's a heavy there, and I'm actually gonna try to take him down from full health with the shotgun, which might not have been the greatest idea, because a WM1 pyro comes around the corner and I die from the afterburn, plus I think that was the Natasha. So never a good combo there when you're running away from an afterburn and a Natasha heavy gets a hold of you. But anyways, I die there. The enemy was able to take the second point. That just means the round will go on for longer, which is always fun. So I've actually been getting a lot of requests for a video like this. It's actually probably been the most requested weapon for me to use the rocket jumper, and that's actually pretty odd to me. I guess maybe that's because it's more one of those fun weapons where you just mess around with. It's not really very practical in any serious play, I guess. It is a fun weapon. I will use it a lot just to mess around, I guess. But if you really want to be serious about the soldier, you probably don't want to be using this weapon too much. It does really limit the soldier's ability, and it does hinder your team a little bit, because the soldier is always good for things like taking down sentry guns, and that's one of the problems you will run into, even though I don't really run into it in this video. I thought I would point that out. Things like sentry guns you are going to be basically useless against. So just things like that, it really does hurt your team a little bit, so don't go around with a rocket jumper all the time. It's always good to be able to actually fire rockets at damage people. But anyways, kind of just roaming around the second point, being a little bit careful here, but still doing a lot of the damage with my shotgun. I thought I was actually able to take down 5 people with my shotgun in like 30 seconds, which is always nice. Can actually show you here how useful the shotgun can be, because I know with my regular soldier I probably don't take the shotgun out quite as much as I should, but now you can hopefully see how useful the shotgun can be for the soldier, even though he doesn't have his rockets. But right now, doing a lot of work here. We're actually pushing on to the last point with quite a bit of authority, I guess we'll say. We actually have quite a bit of a nice push here, and I'm actually going to probably chase down the sniper, because I don't even know why. I just decided to chase him down, why not? He's about to kill my medic. I'll try to support him. And my medic's able to get that nice kill there, and with that, that means victory for us. So I guess I would say top fragging like a boss. Medics don't count as top fragging. I just kind of made that rule up, but I'll just say it. So yeah, top fragging like a boss here as a rocket jumping soldier. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. Please subscribe if you want to see more videos like these in the future, and thanks for watching.